Hi, I'm Mike Massimino, and this is Inside the International Space Station.
Well, not really. You feel like you're not missing everything.
Tell people, you know, we can call them, but they can't call us.
Yeah. Give me a break. Don't call so much.
For grandkids floating in space.
And we're going to talk with Joe Acaba and Suni Williams about their upcoming space flight.
You know, I think the space station life and training, everything fits my personality a little bit better than shuttle. You know, shuttle is pretty, like Joe said, pretty direct, and you know what you're going to do, and boom, boom, boom. And for station, it's pretty much like, well, we'll see what happens, like Joe said, when you get there, and you sort of have to be flexible. And I think I live my life a little bit like that. We'll see what happens, and it's okay. And I think it's a little bit of a change of pace. It's maybe a little bit slower in some regards, but it's a marathon, so you have to be ready to do this for a long time. And I like that. I like that better, actually, I think, than this rush shuttle flight. And actually, one of the really cool things about it is you get to engage people on the ground when you're up there for a long time. Folks know that we're going. We're launching out of Kazakhstan, so it's a long trip. It's expensive. Not many of your guests get to go to launch, but that's okay because you're going to be up in space for a long time, and you get to interact with them for 6 months. For example, my dad and my mom aren't going. They're a little bit older, and I said, don't go. And they're feeling bad about it. I said, you know, the launch is only you know, the first 8 minutes really, and then the rest of the time we'll be in space. 6 months we'll be on the space station. We'll be able to use the phone and the internet to, you know, do net meeting and see you down on the ground. So that's okay. So I like the space station idea, just because you can bring a whole bunch of people along with you for 6 months. They're watching what you're doing. If you have the ability to write a journal or send down pictures or tweet or do Facebook and stuff like that from space, it really engages a lot of people. And I think that's really important. And it's good for kids in school and other organizations. So it's fun. It's going to be fun.
It's interesting you said, because sometimes one would think, not knowing what the experience you've had, is that you're going into space, you're going to be, you know, you have your crewmates, but it's kind of like you're isolated.
Yeah.
You know, you're in your own world, more or less, but almost literally. You know, you're off the planet.
Mm-hmm.
Everyone else is here, right? And you're like, everybody else is here, and you're up there. But really, the way you describe it is that you're actually connected.
Oh yeah, I think so. I think you bring everybody along. My sister said last time, I would write a journal on Sunday night, so they would get up, her and her friends, and at work, they would all get in their inbox on Monday morning, and they would read it, and it was like the New York Times or the Boston Globe. They were like, hey, after you come back, you have to keep writing a journal, because every Monday morning, we read your journal. And I said, oh, no way. There's more in my life you don't want to know about on the ground. Space, I could do that, no problem.
You find you have more time to do that stuff in space than you do on the ground, too? Because you get back to Earth, and it's
crazy.
You get back into the routine where maybe you have even more time.
Yeah, I think up in space you do. You feel like you're, from my last flight, you feel like you're rushed because you have a lot of stuff on the timeline that you're trying to do all the time. But they give you part of the weekend off, and, you know, it's a good thing because you got time to look out the window, time to enjoy the planet, and then try and relay that to the folks on the ground, because we're really lucky. You know, there's only a handful of us who get to see that, and I wish I could bring everybody, all my family and friends up here. You wouldn't believe how beautiful this is, and you try to capture it, and luckily we now have 3D camera or 3D video camera and HD cameras up there, so we do the best that we can to send the stuff back down, but I think some of the human emotion is important too. You journal that and send that out, and people can sort of feel like they're there with you.
Yeah. You mentioned, you know, the way you stay connected. On the flights I had, we didn't have a phone. We went to Hubble, nobody was there. You know, if there's anybody there, we'd probably turn right back around. But the phone thing, you know, I've gotten calls from some of our friends from up there, and it's pretty hilarious when it happens. Have you had a lot of fun with surprising people?
Oh yeah,
Like, trick people? Do you prank phone calls and order pizza? What is someone? What, I mean, because people must.
That's a good idea.
I mean, I can give you ideas like that. Yeah. You can do stuff I would do. it's a big thing to get a phone call from. So I mean, what it must be. And we're astronauts, right? So when you call, do you have some funny experiences?
People don't believe it. They're like, no, where are you? Why are you calling? Or, you know, we thought you were in space. Where are you? When did you come home? I missed it. But it is surprising to a lot of folks. They don't realize that actually we have a phone in space. And, you know, it's not your cell phone, but it is a phone. And when we have the great connection, we can call. And you can call anywhere. And it's great because it really does keep you connected to, you know, your family. because we have video conference once a week, but it's a perfect thing to be able to remember everybody's birthday and be able to call them and say happy birthday.
You listen, Joe?
Well, now I got to make a list for birthdays. I didn't plan on doing that, but now they all know I can use this phone.
Yeah, holidays and stuff like that. At least you feel like you don't miss it entirely. I remember being put on speakerphone and folks down on the ground having a party, and you can hear, you know, glasses tinking, you know, chinking and stuff like that. And it's nice. It sort of connects. I think it's good for folks on the ground, but it's also really good for us because you feel like you're not missing everything. When you're up there and you know parties are going on and stuff like that, and you're, oh, I'm not there. If you can make a phone call down and everybody wants to talk to you and say hi, it makes you feel like you're involved.
What about you, Jordan? You got to use the phone on your first flight.
Yeah, the phone is nice. And, the good thing about the phone, we always tell people, we can call them, but they can't call us.
Oh, that's only one direction, that's right? Key.
But a lot of people, they get a phone number, on their caller ID from Houston. I don't want to talk to Joe today. And so you leave a message on their, answering machine, like, oh, man, I missed this call. Yeah. And so that's always good, and they enjoy having that. And it is. It's a great way to connect with people, and, it's just as good for us as it is for the people you call. It's pretty cool.
Did you have anybody not believe it was you when you called? I don't even have how much time to call Sonny did, but not believe you?
What I thought was cool is when I called my grandmother, for her to get a phone call from space where, she grew up, didn't have a phone, probably didn't have electricity. Wow. She grew up, pretty rural in Puerto Rico, and, so for her to do that, and when we had a, one of the private family conferences, for her to see her grandkid floating in space, it was pretty cool.
Actually, speaking about the phone, though, my husband was getting tired of me calling.
Really?
He said, we talk to each other more that you're in space now. He said, you're not doing anything up there. Get to work, because I'm tired of you calling me so much.
I've heard this problem before. Sometimes the kids, are glad, like, the parents are gone. Right. And
give me a break. Don't call
much. Yeah, stop annoying me. Come back to Earth where you're busy. But he really said that, though.
Sort of joking around. He said, we talk more now that you're in space than when you're at home.
That is funny. Do it!